Okay, so we are back with painting a portrait in airbrush. We are doing that in India ink. The internet is really bad. Right now the internet connection is so slow. I think it would be damaging to go with Facebook right now. We're just gonna do YouTube for now because some broadcast is better than no broadcast. Just want to establish that dark over here, and then some of this sort of wispy shadow. You want to make sure that you don't get too dark, and it's also important to get that really nice contour here. Kind of looks like Scarlett Johansson a little bit, but it's not. I don't want to get too dark. There's plenty of time to get dark, that's for sure. How are you? My air compressor went off. It's a little late. This is probably going to be the last of this. Thank you so much for coming back. The internet is so slow. Even though I have like an incredible internet connection with Verizon Fios here, my internet connection is so slow. Now, I'm so light, you know, and I'm glad you didn't lose me forever. I'm going to go darker, and I'm just really trying to get a good feeling. Yeah, maybe it's the Russians, right? Who knows what's going on? I wouldn't be surprised. I gotta put some tape on my reference. It keeps blowing away. Now, we have a nice contour of the dark of her hair with the ear. So let's go ahead and use our freehand shield. Definitely want to get that beautiful edge, right? I think it is the Russians. I guess once they feel they sabotage my life feed, the rest of the country will fall. Exactly, that's true. It's so many really wonderful edges that we have to make sure that we pay attention and don't lose. We can lower that air pressure a little bit. We have such thin ink, the viscosity is so thin that we could really lower the air pressure a lot and not have any problems. So I was at the, as you know, when, oh, the ratio of this is 3 full eyedroppers of water to 2 eyedrops, 2 drops of the India ink. And that's a really light tone, light value. It's this one right here. So see how light that is. And watch, you know, it's really on the money. See, you go like this, and it's pretty darn close to the value. So using this chart, you're pretty much gonna nail exactly what value you like. Now, with anything else, when you go over it, since it's a transparent, as you continue going over a transparent with itself, it gets darker and darker with each layer. So be mindful of that. Now, why you wouldn't go ahead and just continue with one value, one ratio like that, is because you oversaturate the surface. So when you have, you go gradually darker and darker using less water and more ink, you're saturating the surface a lot less. So that's good. You know what? Definitely. I would definitely, when you get a chance, buy one of these. That's what I did. I bought one of these. And these are like $2, $3. And it's the Higgins Waterproof India ink. And just use this and then refill it. It comes with the eyedropper. That would be your best route. Yeah, your ink's gonna last you forever. You know, I was on this forum early in the week because I was looking at people who were following my blog. And I came on this forum, this airbrush forum, and they were, yes, the 40% off coupon would be perfect. Get yourself one of them and you're set. And then just use that little, use this, and then when it runs low, use your big thing of ink and keep refilling it. That's what I do. So what was I saying? I was saying something. I forgot. Couldn't have been that important. As you can see, oh yeah, the airbrush form. Thank you so much. So they were talking about the how horrible it is to work with ink, and you know, because this one guy was like, well, I want to work with India ink and airbrush, and so many people were saying, no, don't do it because it has lacquer in it, all these like really weird, like strange answers. And then one person goes, why don't you check out the live streams of Timothy John Luke Smith, because he uses ink through his airbrush. And I never heard from the guy, but now it's weird. I heard him say something like, I don't think so. I mean, I've been using India ink since 2003. I've never had any kind of issue with that. I think it's just dye. And if it is any kind of lacquer, it must be a very, like, negligible amount. That's what I think. I like the way the ink is really reacting to the paper. We're still light, so things are eventually going to come together. But remember, we worked with the sepia, and we didn't have any problems whatsoever. maybe they're not using artist ink. Maybe they're using like ink that people use to write calligraphy or something. Because even with Higgins, there's like several different inks. There's the Black Magic ink that a lot of people use, but that's not waterproof. And it has a totally different qualities. But isn't this, I'm really enjoying the way the Micron works with the ink. That's what I'm thinking. They're not the same. They're totally different. And one like this is used for blending, doing really nice blending, and it's archival and waterproof. So this is more for your artists. Illustrators have been using this forever. Eventually, I'm going to be erasing a lot, so let's do some erasing. But it's interesting, I mean, that people will give up on a medium before they ever start. And I think that's what it is. I mean, people are fixated when using airbrush paint for an airbrush. So I'm going to try coming in with the colored pencil right away. I mean the pastel pencil right away. Yeah, I would think so. I think using ink for a fountain pen would definitely be much more toxic, because they probably don't even imagine anyone ever using it, through an airbrush. At least something like the Higgins Waterproof India ink, I think they have an idea of, how an illustrator, because they're geared for the old time illustrators. But it's cool that we can just sort of work things out as we go. And here we have a light value. And we can just go ahead and just start it. Sort of work. You know, it's so true. I dilute the ink just ridiculously, right? And it's mostly water. Now this is gonna be a test where what would happen if when I'm working on the ink, right, and I put the pastel down, and what happens when the ink, a little bit of the ink goes over the pastel? What's going to happen? We're going to find out. We're going to experiment here and find out exactly what's happening. Now, white ink for the highlights, that would be good, but I would have a lot less wiggle room. See, with this, Wendy, I can just go like this and highlight's gone. But if I go in with the ink, I don't have as much license to erase and go back. So I definitely don't like that aspect. So I'm going to stick with this. Yeah, so I think it might be best for us to have that ability just to, you know, change gears and maybe just change our highlights here and there. And, you know, just like, now this is where the drawing aspect comes in, right? You know, we did all those drawings, same thing, we're going to lighten and darken our highlights using the stump and also using the eraser, the kneaded eraser. Yeah, it just makes our life easier. And a lot of times, like when I was in Harvey's studio and Harvey would see me like waiting to put in the highlights, he's like, what are you waiting for? Just go in there. You know, and that's what my thinking is now when I'm, you know, the way I was at the academy during that one class. Why wait to put the highlights in? Just go ahead and start working them in, and then you can adjust and make them go away, bring them back, right? So, and basically we're just going to gauge this. I'm going to blend that out. Right now it looks quite scary. So, okay, so let's see if I can find that stump dedicated just for the white. And same as when we were drawing. Just gonna calm this down. And what we're doing is we're setting up the midtones, and we're able to, when we establish these lights, we enable this midtone of the paper to be stronger, because without the white, we would see the mid-tone of the paper. Thanks, Wendy. We'll see the mid-tone of the paper as starting to become a nice dark. It's almost like sculpting. Just, you know, working things together. Okay. Now we're doing the white. Let's see if we can just continue with her neck. Some highlights here. Ear is very white in areas. I'll tell you, going to the Met on Monday really was inspirational. You know, just makes you realize how, you know, art is the same, even though it's hundreds of years ago, still the same. They have the same bug as us, you know? Some were lucky enough to have very lucrative careers, and you know, some went through a lot of hard times before they became famous. Yeah, I'm telling you, Wendy, it's hard to leave. I know exactly how you feel. Okay, so let's see if we can lift that up a little bit. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in a little darker. And work on these shapes. And then eventually what I want to do, what my goal is to get rid of all the pencil lines and just replace it with ink. So in essence, it looks like I just worked with ink straight. And like I said, we want to get rid of all of the pencil lines. And that's what we're working towards. You want to do that, but you don't want to lose the drawing, right? That's important. You work so hard to get that drawing down. It'd be a shame to lose it. Before, Wendy, I would actually wait to go in with the highlights and wait to go in with the darks. But I think I'm getting a little more comfortable with this technique here. Also, I'm going to do something a little radical here. I'm going to take my ink and I am going to do something. I am going to go in with. Now I got a problem with glare here a little bit. With the paintbrush. Now, since I have the glare, I'm going to be real simple. Yes, exactly. That's so true. That's something to really explore, Wendy, with the pastel and the ink. And my feeling is, why wait, right? Let's go right in with that real nice dark. The nostril. So it's a little bold, right? Let's make that bigger. Oh, wrong way. Oh yeah, the yes, exactly. The close-ups are really cool, and we do have to hold our breath, right? When we go in with some really strong darks. But these are more for structure. They're not really the dark accents just yet. But I do want to get the drawing down. And so I'm going to use the brush because I can. Really does have a girl with a pearl earring feel, this pose. Let's pull this up. Going to just do things that we can with the airbrush, with the paintbrush. That would be a little bit more difficult with the airbrush. Let's pull this back. There we go. Just hit some darks here. Always clean that paintbrush up. Wipe that clean before, because ink will do a number on your paintbrushes. Not so much as acrylic will, but still, it'll beat them up pretty bad. Okay, let's go back to our really light paint mixture. See if we can work on that here a little more. Same thing with her lips here. Be very careful not to oversaturate that. It can easily happen. Yeah, this is a really fun technique. Now everything looks dark right now, but when we start lessening the reduction of water to airbrush in later layers, we're really going to see things change. Everything's going to lighten up. And this, of course, is where I can enlarge that nostril. Wow, I've been on for 2 hours. Goes by quick when you're having fun. I think it's just you and me here on YouTube right now, right? I'm gonna work until my compressor runs out of air because it's so late. I don't want it to wake anybody up. Oh, if you oversaturate, yeah, it starts to warp. And, like pastel, it won't accept more water and it'll just start getting weird. won't accept more, you know, more wet ink. So if you see, Wendy, I don't stay in one area. I keep moving. I'll darken it on the next pass, you know? No, they didn't. Yeah, so that's cool. I mean, we had a lot of people on Facebook today. That was good. That was encouraging. A lot more encouraging than last week. We're gonna let this dry a bit. How is that? Is that a little bit light? How's that on your end? No way. Like you said too many comments or something? Never. They want you to say comments. At least I would hope so. And what's interesting, oh, well, thank you, Wendy. I appreciate it. We're in the early stages. This is baby steps, right? But we already, like, this is a very encouraging start. And as we go, we're going to get rid of these pencil marks. The trick is, when you remove the graphite, that you don't lose the drawing. That you only lose the drawing when you reiterated the drawing with the ink. So you see where wow. So they actually sent you a message? No way. That would be crazy. But I'll tell you, YouTube is crazy. They're crazy. Some of their decisions lately, they really, you know, with the partner program and just catering to whoever has a lot of views. Really? Like, who are you commenting on? My videos or somebody else's? You know what it was? I bet it was a moderator. Oh, look at that. Look at how I got so dark over here. Okay. Yeah, that's better. Yeah. Really, my video, I don't have a moderator, so that was YouTube. Don't listen to them. You could talk as much as you want. I think they're crazy. Wow. YouTube, you're out there. Leave my channel alone. Let my people talk as much as they want. I want that. Wow. As they say in Spanish, cálmate, mijo. That's what I would say to them. It's not your fault. You're helping my channel. They don't really want small channels to succeed. And that's something I know. They want the big channels to succeed. And they'll do anything to propagate that. Like, tell my people to stop chatting on my... That's the whole idea of this, is that the interchange of ideas. That's the whole idea of a live stream. Otherwise, what's the point? Here's a test. Let's see what happens when we go over the white with the ink. Exactly. And my live streams never have 100 people. Okay, so now let's work on this contour here. Yes, and it's so hard, I think of those little sea turtles and how once they get to a certain size, then they're sort of out of harm's way, but it's getting to that size from being a little baby sea turtle, that's the hardest to surviving. Is it too light or too dark right now? I could adjust the lights, Wendy. Remember the top? That's so important. Oh, great. Thanks, Wendy. I'm glad. And we are staying very, very general at this point. And everything is so light. Oh, thanks. Well, I think it's all about the drawing, right? I think the drawing really, really hit well. And we're gonna crawl that along. Oh, my mini tripod's in the way. So I'm gonna work until I run out of air in my compressor, because I turned it off so it doesn't refill, so this way I don't wake up the neighbors. My neighbor has to get up at like 4 in the morning. There we go. Remember, we got plenty of time to go darker, so we're not going to go too dark, because that's what the lesser reduction. Yeah, you see, you can definitely see the difference. If I had a little compressor, I would not be able to work right now. I had an even bigger compressor, and that was really good. Hardly ever went off. Okay, let's see if we can work on some of that hair. Yeah, I could imagine the air pressure, the compressor going off all the time. That would drive me crazy as well. Funny, I never thought I would be doing airbrush paintings. I started it in my 40s. You just never know. We always got to stay open to new things. This is almost like sketching with the airbrush. Went a little crazy there, huh? The control with the Micron Wendy is really great. And like I said, it's like having a crazy relationship that drives you crazy, yet it, you know, you just, you know, it's just such a rush. That's what the microns feel like. And you see, we're just basically establishing just establishing the larger shapes, and little by little we're getting rid. It is hard to go back to the eclipse, but you know, the eclipse is just so reliable, and it feels good to know that it's gonna be working 100% for you. It's true, it doesn't, and I think that's great. You know how long it would take me? Now, no way am I condoning not drawing, but this is a much faster way than just going in with graphite. This would be like week number two or three. Maybe week three that we would get at this point. And look how fast everything is sort of happening. It looks like a drawing. It really does. It really does look like a drawing. Yes, so much faster. And look how we're setting up the lights. We're getting there, you know? I mean, it's not bad. We got a hit on the lights here, I think. So, the thing is, we can keep going back with pencil and going in with the airbrush, erasing, and we have the just this great ability to just move around and do stuff. Wow, thank you, Wendy. That's a very nice compliment. I appreciate that. Okay, so we're gonna need some really intricate. Let's go in tight. We're gonna do some intricate freehand shield work. I'm just gonna crawl along this edge here. And it takes a while to really get a feel of using the freehand shield and not going over the area that you are covering. So now that I went ahead, let me make sure, blow some air on that, dry that up. And then we can come in with the eraser. Look at that, that is so weird, Wendy. Wow. I guess they're afraid of somebody who is in like a group, like a live stream that has like you said, 100 people and not giving other people a chance. But you're it. You're everybody. So it doesn't work in this case. Zoom back out. Okay. So we started, we're going to get much darker, of course, but we definitely began the contour of her nose there. The good thing is we can even erase the ink, so that's going to really come in handy. Exactly. Believe me, my live streams, I need everyone talking at all times. I had some live streams like on Twitch where there was nobody, not a soul. So I was sort of like talking to myself. But you see those live streams that do really well, they're talking nonsense. I mean, they're just like, wow. Just the level of intellect is really quite scary. Yes, it could, and it does, you know. Then I see other airbrush artists. 1,200 people? What? And the work is, oh, I don't even want to say, but. Anyway, 1,200 people, 1,400 people, and you're like, really? And hey, I want everyone to succeed, right? Definitely. And I'm happy for their success, but I'm wondering, you know, what's the difference? Yeah, you know, a lot of the YouTube videos are just like, even like people who I follow who are like, you know, wildly successful, and I enjoy a lot of their how-to videos, but when they start just doing their vlogs and it's just like silliness, like really juvenile, I have to say I can't do it. Really? Oh, fast forward someone's videos, not their live streams though. But yeah, that does help sometimes. Or I'm guilty of like fast forwarding through the introduction when I know it's gonna say, please like and subscribe, even though my videos I do that, you know? We're just in that type of we're in that type of mindset that we don't wanna wait, right? And I'm guilty of that. Oh no. Yeah, and I think a lot of people get hooked on in live streams on entertaining people. And well, thank you. I don't want to, I want to be entertaining in a sense. I want everyone to be part of it, and I want to learn from you guys as much as you guys learn from me. And I don't want someone to just, you know, be just a spectator. I know there may come a time when I have so many views, so many people, it might be hard. I see some of the, like the live streams that are so many people that this part right here goes so fast, and I don't see how they can possibly read it. But I guess when they get that big, they have a moderator who can help, you know, get some of the better questions. But I just like the informality of it, right? And yes, exactly, like how Mr. Greenberg's class was in high school, or Harvey's class at the academy, or George Pasquantino's class. You know, each had a different flavor, and the art teachers made you feel like you were an artist, not just a student, like a fellow painter. So pretty soon I'm going to start going in with a darker value. That's going to be next week, is I'll go in with a darker value. So right now, let's see. So right now we're at here, 3 and 2. So I'll probably go with, I would say I'll jump 2 and go right here, which is dreeful eyedroppers of water and 4 drops of ink ratio, and go with this darkness. And then after that, do a little bit of this. Whoop, where is that? Okay, put it right here. A little bit of this value. And this is about as dark as I go. I might go a little bit dark with the accents, but that's really gonna pop things out. So I think it has a really nice look to it. It does have that sort of 19th century drawing look to it. And I'm a little bit, yes, definitely get that that bottle of India ink. That would really help you. Yeah, you know, I want everyone. Oh, thanks. I love to pose. And as you can see, I'm getting rid of a lot of the pencil lines and making sure as I'm doing that, I'm not losing the drawing. So erase the pencil lines, but make sure you reiterate those drawing lines with the ink. So that's what I'm going to do before I end this live stream, is I'm just going to erase and then reiterate with the ink. So what happens, Wendy, is that we end up having nothing but ink and no more pencil. But as you can see, we have to be very careful that we don't lose the hard work we did with the pencil. Yeah, it's so true. Now, if you erase a little bit harder, the ink will start coming off, so that's good. So you have that wiggle room for correction and for pulling out darks. Hi, my kitty's right over there. What? Don't come on the table. So right now it's all about, yeah, the cat. She's so cute. I think she thinks she's a dog. Looks like Charlize Theron, but it's not. Maybe it is, I don't know. I just found this picture. Right? I think it looks like her, like when she did the, what was that? Devil's Advocate. Like around that age. Al Pacino's an amazing actor. Really strong dark here. But I'm gonna wait, I'm just gonna darken a little bit, but I'm gonna wait for the darker mixture of the ink and water, but I'm just going to establish. Oh my god, look at the cat behind me. She's crazy. What are you doing? Huh? What are you doing? Okay, so it looks like I can't see your comments right now all of a sudden, but it looks like I'm still on YouTube. Let me double check here. Yeah, it's just a lot of weirdness tonight with these live streams. I am okay, YouTube, let's go back. Okay, I'm gonna end this anyway, but thanks Wendy for stopping by, and it's always great to talk to you on my live streams. But I think I'm pretty happy with where we are. Let me do some of this mid-tone here first. Move this up. Okay. Okay. Sort of have like a little bit going up there on her chin. Okay, so I will definitely call it a night. This has been 2.5 hours. So thank you, Wendy, if you're out there. For some reason, the comment part went away. But thank you so much for hanging out and all your great comments. And I hope you have a great night, and I will talk to you soon. And tomorrow we'll work on your opaque projector, okay? Take care of yourself. Bye.